Excuse me, sir. You work here?
No, I just hang around here for fun. I'm joking. How can I help you, friend?
I know this sounds crazy. Some dumb old coot I know is telling me there's these houses you can buy pre-cut.
Not crazy, friend. The very latest in modern convenience. Convenient and cost-efficient. Which house do you want? Each one is entirely unique, but also the same.
Excuse me?
Perhaps I'm going too fast, sir. Do you want to buy a house?
I think so.
I'll give you a luxurious, entirely unique pre-cut palace. And if you order today, I guarantee your home in a matter of weeks, maybe sooner.
I'll take that one.
Ah, yes, we have that one in stock.
And I already got credit from the bank.
Oh, fantastic. You write your name here, and you sign your name there, and you will be the proud owner of a factory-built home.
It's that easy.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Martin. Albert Cakes, Esquire, at your service.
You boys give me a minute.
What are you doing here? Everything okay?
I'm not sure. Probably. A fella came by the farm. Got attacked on the road. He said the Skinner brothers was hanging around. Lots of them. Left Uncle armed to the teeth back at the ranch.
Who are these two?
Guns for hire. If they're Skinner's about, we need them.
We ain't got that kind of money, Charles.
You want to get robbed for your house?
No, but...
Hey, these Skinners can be nasty. Come on. Mr. Devon, you're with me. Mr. Wayne, this is...
Milton. Jim Milton.
Sir, good to meet you.
We're going to be heading up to the Manzanita Post.
Why?
The best smith around is that Norwegian fella up there.
So they say. You boys ready?
Yes, sir, we're ready.
Good, because you're about to get shot at over a goddamn hammer.
You want to build a house with a sniper rifle, then?
I know old Neil's real well. I'll get you a good deal.
Thank you, sir. All right, then. Let's go buy us some tools.
I know the quickest way. Follow me.
Say, is your friend a Negro or a Redskin?
I think a bit of both, for what it's worth.
Cash is cash, though it's all the same to me. I saw you getting skittish there, but don't you worry. We're not getting shot at.
Oh, yeah. I know Charles Smith. If he's got cause to be concerned, it's usually good cause.
You got a shotgun messenger sitting right beside you, all right? I suppose you don't know much about robbing caravans.
Not much, I guess. No.
Well, nor do I. But I know a thing or two about protecting them. And if a robber sees some strong men sitting up front, two of them guns for hire, then they're gonna wait for the next set of fools to come on through.
Unless they take the guns to mean they're carrying something valuable. Instead of pre-cut timber and some tools.
What? No. Wait, look, trust me on this. You are overthinking it. You hire a gun, you hire peace of mind and a deterrence. So I'll sit here looking big and scary, and you can concentrate on the horses.
All right. I'll do just that.
Maybe I've done this kind of thing before, and maybe I can handle a weapon. But I'm not so different from you, partner.
Hey! We're taking the next right up towards Manzanita Post.
What were you saying again?
I think you might be.
People wonder how you can handle it, living by your gun. But it's the same as any other occupation, really. When I get home, I put my gun on the rack and it stays there. I mean it. It really stays there. I don't even think about it. My mind's on my wife and the little ones. I'm chopping wood, mending the roof, putting the kids to bed. But when I'm out here, I'm watching the tree line. I got my gun at the ready. And I'm trying to make my employer as comfortable as possible.
That's, real good of you.
You're in good hands. I know this country well.
Good. Am I finally gonna meet this tool maker?
Now, Niels, he's an acquired taste, but boy, can he work metal. Norwegian, you see? Viking blood. Fellas up there used to worship a god with a hammer. Guess I figures they'd still be making them. I'm not sure how much English he speaks, but Niels knows tools.
This is the spot, just up ahead.
Okay.
You boys wait here. After you, Mr. Milton.
Like I said, Niels is a...
Niels. Niels, it's me. Willard Wayne.
Okay.
This is my associate, Jim Milton.
Okay.
He heard you was the best. Best smith around. He needs some tools. He's building a ranch house up at Beecher's Hope.
Beecher's Hope? Okay.
Have you got any made?
Okay.
Like I said, an acquired taste, but a heart of gold, and he's the best. You off someplace, Nils?
Okay.
So Milton is working with Cakes Hardwood and Timber in town. Should I get them to pay you and add it to his bill up there?
Okay.
Come on, let's get moving.
Okay.
All right, Beecher's Hope. They've been trying to sell that property for some time, hadn't they? Took a look at it myself, as it so happens. Seemed like a lot of work. Too much for me. But more power to you. Must have seen something in it I couldn't. World needs men like you. And...
Whoa! Everyone find some cover! Hold on over there!
God damn!
Keep your head down!
Poke your brain.
He's running at you! Machete! Watch him!
You okay?
Watch out for arrows!
I don't like this one bit.
Look there!
More of these bastards!
Willard, how you holding up there? We'll get you out of here!
Nice!
Hold tight, Willard!
Look out! Devin, you okay?
Yes.
Is that the last of them?
I think so.
There's more! They got the tools!
They grabbed Mr. Wayne!
All right, you stay here, guard the wagons. Charles, come on!
What are you... Oh.
Thank you.
gotta be gaining on him.
I hope so. You're coming out of nowhere. Oh! Oh!
No, no. You see what? Anything?
Hold on, Mr. Wang!
Finish him off. Please, God, no.
You're dead.
We cleared him. Keep going.
Where's Wade? Mr. Wade!
Can you hear us?
Charles, I found the tools. Now, where's Mr. All right. Shit. Jesus. We gotta move fast. Come on. Charles, you all right carrying him?
I got it. There's no use in you getting bloody, too.
Is it bad?
They opened him up pretty good. Nearly chopped his head in two.
God damn them!
Mr. Wade didn't make it.
Here, Horde, no.
We have to get out of here. You take him in the back wagon. Come on, help me!
All right, let's get out of here.
Oh, my Lord. What'd they do to him?
Nothing nice.
Got it.
Come on, we gotta go.
Shit. Those goddamn animals.
Okay.
John, I'm riding with you.
Get us back to Beaches.
Those were the Skinner brothers.
I told you I was worried.
Sadie said something too. What kind of land have I bought?
It's not the land. The Skinners move around. They're here for now.
I thought this kind of bloodshed was meant to be over with.
Damn it, John. You'll run the horses into the ground.
What was all the nonsense about civilization?
This kind of bloodshed is different. Folks have been killed, sure. For good reason and bad. But rarely just for the fun of it.
Uncle! Uncle! Uncle!
I was...
You useless sack of crap.
I was keeping guard.
Really?
Whoa. What happened?
Skinner brothers.
A lot of them?
Enough.
Once this is done... I'll take Mr. Devon back to town.
Get poor Mr. Wayne buried.
Okay. Be careful.
Well, I will. But I'm fairly sure we scared him off for now.
Bad business. Well, we'll be safe together.
Sure. If you say so.
And John. I love you. Don't you forget that.
Those plans make any sense?
Oh, sure.
Seems easy enough, I think.
How hard can it be? But I'll tell you what I think, just to be safe.
I'll do the reading and planning, and
You do the building.
How did I know you'd try to weasel out of doing any work?
Oh, now, that is plain unfair. It's inaccurate and not what's going to happen. I'm simply going to use what I've got, which is a brain. Why you use what you've got, which is less of a brain.
Let's get started.
Well, first thing it says the foundation, which involves moving those heavy wooden joists. Definitely not a job for a man with terminal lumbago, unless you want to dig a 6-foot-deep hole for me when the work day's over.
Don't tempt me.
Oh, well, here comes Charles. Maybe he can lighten the mood a little.
How'd you get on?
He'll be back, but not for a while.
Charles, dear boy, John needs help moving these joists. Now, come on. Get a move on. We gotta get started before the rains come.
You're very annoying.
He's right. We should get on with this.
Saw in a board and I'll cut it. I'll climb up a ladder with a hammer and a nail and I'll nail it. Well, we worked so hard to build a little house together. In the snow or the rain or the ice cold wind, whenever, no matter what the weather, we're together.
I think that's everything.
John Marston, you have a home.
So do you.
Oh, I know.
And you, Charles, as long as you'll stay with us.
Thank you.
Gentlemen,
to this happy home. At least till this fool gets his woman back.
My darling Abigail, I hope you and Jack are doing well. I remain a fool, and I'm sure I shall die a fool. But I'm trying very hard to be something like the man you deserve. I have done something very silly in an effort to impress you. And that is, I've purchased a home. The land you read about in the newspaper up at Beecher's Hope is now ours, and we are going to try our hand at ranching. Mr. Geddes kindly helped me buy the land. I met Uncle while I was coming out of the bank, and while I know your feelings about him, he has been enormously helpful in his own fashion. Charles Smith has also appeared and is unsurprisingly a pillar of strength. Together, we've built you a home. I hope soon to show it to you. I miss you and the boy more than I can express. Please, come back to me. Yours always, John. Uncle, I thought you was... Where the hell? Just one time I hope to find you working. Just once.
Do you believe in reincarnation, John Marston?
No.
Well, I hope and pray to whatever is out there that I get to come back as a youngin, so that when you're old and facing death, I can be some two-penny slave driver that comes along and hastens your journey into the grave. This is a fatal condition I got.
And I'll give you another fatal condition. We don't get on with things around here, and we'll all starve.
Get on with what?
Farming, ranching, planting something.
The only thing that this land's good for is grazing.
Grazing?
Yeah, so cows, sheep, goats. Now, goats is easy, but they taste awful.
I don't like goats. And cows, I've seen enough cows.
Yeah, sheep then. But any livestock, you're gonna need a barn.
Barn will take three of us 6 months to build.
Oh, you don't build a barn, dumbass. What do you think this is, 1785? You buy one pre-cut just like the house. This is the industrial age. The lumber fellers all have them.
That guy makes me hate the modern world.
Oh, come on. I'll deal with him.
I can't move like I used to. Man, I never was that fast. In the backwater.
Let's go.
Well done, girl.
Now, this fella probably saw you, thought, here's some corn husk idiot, some country rube, doesn't know a pre-cut home from an outhouse. And I'm gonna rob him blind. I gotta respect him for it. 'Cause if I saw you walk into my lumberyard, I'd think exactly the same thing.
Thinking about it? I might actually do this on my own.
Oh, I can't let you do that, John. Let you get robbed again? Oh, no. You need someone with some sense to negotiate. And some charm wouldn't hurt neither.
And that's... you, is it? With your famous way with people?
You're in enough debt as it is. I got to help you all I can.
It's my debt. I'll handle it.
Yeah, but if they foreclose on the debt, I'll lose my home. And I do so like it there. Just wait right there for me.
And how are we? How's little Emily?
Emily?
I'm sorry, how are you?
We need a barn.
A barn? Of course you do. All them potatoes.
We're gonna farm livestock.
What's wrong with you? How many Scarface loons you got coming in here buying pre-cut homes?
Here, what you think? Have a look.
Maybe that one.
That
one. An excellent choice. We have a couple already cutting in stock. I'll have it sent to you in Blackwater.
I'm down at Beecher's Hope.
Oh, I'm sorry. Of course, this is my wife, Jerry. You see, she's out. It's great seeing you again, Al.
Yeah,
it's been
a pleasure as always. Great pleasure. Love your work.
Of course.
How are we going to pay for this?
Same way we pay for everything.
I just wish I could help you, sir. You've been a good customer, and I like you, and David Geddes likes you.
But
this man is very annoying.
Can you just give me a few days?
Of course.
I really enjoy begging and watching you make a fool of yourself.
John! Hey!
Is that Sadie Adler? Hey.
John, how are you?
Well, hello, Uncle. Nice to see you. Oh, and you too.
Oh, shut up, you old creep.
Listen, Sadie, you got any work? I'm kind of desperate.
Work? How desperate?
I need money. A bunch of money. My debt's climbing, and
you up for a fight?
Is it legal?
Well, it's very legal, but it's also pretty dangerous. With you, it'll be fine, but I wouldn't do it on my own.
I ain't got much choice.
All right, then. Come on.
Look after him, Sadie. He's a delicate flower underneath.
Tell the bank there's money coming in. And get a crew to help with that barn.
I have it on good authority we can find this bounty at Painted Sky.
I know the place.
Okay, I'll follow you. All right, the Painted Sky tip is pretty fresh, but I don't know how long it'll stay that way. An encyclopedia salesman was up there on the property. Couldn't find the rancher, but saw a Mexican-looking feller hanging around. Now, Ramon Cortez is round those parts, split up from his gang and stuck in West Elizabeth. It's gotta be him, holed up, waiting on some out. And we're gonna get to him first. Slow down!
Sadie. Hey, so who is this bounty?
Ramon Cortez. He's with the Del Lobo gang.
Del Lobos?
Yeah. You head back down to where we was, New Austin, you're bound to run into them.
Oh, I ran into them. Mostly Mexicans?
Some of them, but some is Californios. And some are regular Americans, too. They're a misfit bunch.
Just like we were. And they're friendly. Real friendly.
Oh, yeah. Ugh, it's a bad situation down there. Burnings, killings, you name it.
I know something of that.
And not much law except the Sheriff of Tumbleweed. He's making a hell of a go of it, but there ain't much there to hold back the chaos. It's real wild country.
Sounds like he needs all the help he can get.
Maybe drop in on him sometime.
You know, I had some trouble of my own. That gang you was talking about, was they the Skinner brothers?
That's
thank you.
saying?
They ain't nice.
Nice weren't what I heard about them.
Got hold of this feller I'd hired. Ah, he didn't die well.
I'm sorry, John.
We fought back. We was too slow was all. I wish we'd done better for him.
I'm sure you did the best you could. I've heard, the kinds of things they do to men. Unspeakable things. I hope that's the last you see of them.
Me too. But if not, I mean to be ready.
That is wise.
You want to hear something? I built my ranch house.
Good for you! Did you make it out of straw bales?
No. It's one of them pre-cut ones. Me and Charles put it up, and Uncle watched and barked the odd order at us. This is Painted Sky up here.
Looks quiet. Ramon Cortez, you better be. Here. You search that barn. I'll take the main house.
Holler if you get him. Cortez! We've come for you!
It'll all be over soon.
You got him?
I think so. He just tried to kill me.
That's about right. Yeah, that's him. Come on. Let's get him to the sheriff. Come on, Ramon. Let's go for a ride. We're going to Rhodes.
Rhodes?
It's different there now.
That hurt. You want money? Gold? My men are meeting me at Newberry Creek. Take me there. I'll pay you good. Better than any bounty.
Oh, shut up.